afternoon, South Africa, and it's still all about our women of wonder on today's Women's Month-inspired Afternoon Express Masterclass with me, Palisa Tembe. Radio and TV presenter and cookbook curator Ingrid Jones is in the kitchen to help us prepare traditional Malay kosisters, give our bread a botanical infusion, and lamb chops with green beans, feta, and mint. Now, as we are speaking about Ingrid, from publishing numerous magazines to being the founder and director of her own media company and now curating a lockdown recipe book, welcome Ingrid Jones.
Gosh, I wish I was as upbeat as you are. I need to up my game. But I see at least we got the dress code today.
At least we're matching, we're matching. But one thing that I'm so excited to talk to you about and touch base with you about is just your journey. It's truly been remarkable. And I think that so many South Africans can draw inspiration from it. So let's rewind. Let's go all the way to the top of your story.
Okay.
Where you co-founded a fully all-black women-owned media company. Can you just tell us a little about that work?
I started off as a teacher and then started writing and wasn't too bad at it. And then I left teaching and then I joined the radio station and then I did a little bit of TV on the side and I eventually, someone said to me, but why don't you come and work at a magazine company? Which I then did stayed there for about 8-9 years. Then the few black women at the company knew that we were not going to go any further than this. Someone has to die for us to go further up the ladder, which wasn't anytime soon. Mm-hmm. So the three of us decided, because we were already quite senior at the time, to take a stab at the thing called a media company, because by then we kind of knew the ropes. The argument for us always was about a legacy and we can do it. And also we had the know-how to start. So we started, we were three in the beginning. One since left, just way younger than us. So I understand, you know, the millennials move on. And so it's now 12 years later. And can you believe that we are still around? We are still female dominated at the moment, but there are a few males in the company. And we have done from SAA's magazine, Mango, the in-flights, we had three in-flights. We have a over and above the lockdown recipe storytelling book, we've got another magazine that was inspired by this called Kusister.
We've seen print media slowly dying.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We've seen a rise in social media and just this technological revolution. How do you keep up?
Look, you have to. I wake up at 4 a.m.
Sure.
I am wide awake by 5, where I kind of scan the environment in terms of what is happening. I try and allow is the wrong word, but for lack of a better word, to be the people who work for Mikateko Media, allow them to be the best that they are and can be. So I do believe that your staff have to be better than you, because in the end they make you look particularly good, but you have to employ the best, and then you can get the best out of them. And lockdown has also taught me that all of that investment of 10 years, 11 years, now we can literally sit wherever we are in the world and no one needs to supervise anyone. Mm-hmm. People just get on with their jobs. And you said there that magazines are struggling and who, for example, launches a magazine in the middle of lockdown? We did. And it was quite successful. We are on issue 4.
Right now, when looking back and where we are in 2021, transformation in certain industries, are you happy with what you see?
You know, it is a question that comes up every year. And I have this year decided I'm not going to answer or talk about that question anymore.
Mm.
Because it literally asks of us, my particular generation, to do exactly what you have been saying.
Mm.
So if the doors are not open and the ceiling is intact, you literally have to kick it open.
I'm telling you.
You have to smash through the glass ceiling. Mm. And if you don't do it for you, or you get it right for you, you can understand that there will be more than us in the generation after me. You guys are, you know, the next generation. Can you imagine 10 years ago, you and I sitting like this in the studio and having a chat about a cookbook? Not at all. So do I see it as if I have had a part to play in that? Absolutely. But I cannot say this with a massive egotistical crown on my head, because there were so many of us. The thing for me is just that mind plays out in a media space.
Mm.
But change is literally driven by ordinary people making extraordinary choices. And that's the stuff that we don't see. We just are able to highlight what ordinary people are doing.
I love the fact that you went in that direction with your answer, because I think that so many people kind of shift the responsibility, shift the blame to the older generations being able to pave the path for us to walk in the excellence. But I love the fact that you're challenging all the South Africans out there to do it for yourself. Mm-hmm. And that is exactly what you did when it comes to your cookbook. I'm so excited to talk about this, honey, because listen, during lockdown, I struggled. I ran out of ideas. I've got no clue what to cook. I feel like fast food. So please, may you take me through the inspiration and just the process of being able to put together a cookbook of inspiration.
Look, it is probably, I'm not a good cook. I can do a few things fairly well, but I'm good at curating. So I can curate a beautiful table with other people's dishes on top of it, lovely. And so I can make a few things. And so during lockdown, as we were sitting there, like you said, and I started seeing people cooking, and as I watched trends, and I saw this thing happening, and banana loaves were the thing at the time.
I tried it.
Oh, did you? Was it good?
I did muffins, and it was delicious.
Just muffins, nothing extra in it. Okay.
I love you, Ingrid.
Anyway, and then people started baking. And I asked stupidly one day on Facebook, because I use my platforms quite wisely, would people be interested in seeing the heritage food stories of, more specifically, black people?
Yeah.
And black, for me, I need to qualify, because you look at me and then people are like, oh, but you're not black. I speak black from a political perspective, so it's all of us within the spectrum. And so people started answering, yes, I'm in. And it wasn't just my frame of mind that says, okay, black heritage and so on. Everyone responded to it from the South African diverse spectrum.
Yeah.
And then I was put on the spot, so what am I going to do about it? And then I thought, well, I work in the media space. I said, well, guys, why don't we just do a book? So this is curated by me, not done by me. There are fantastic women in there, not just women, males, and everyone contributing. And it became less about the food, but more about what's the story behind this dish. Mm-hmm. Because a cuisister is a cuisister is a cuisister, and a green bean stew is a green bean stew is a green bean stew. What is it that inspired your matriarch or patriarch to bring that dish to a level where, you know, an auntie will say, but I literally make the best green bean stew.
The Lockdown Recipe Storytelling Book is a must-have, and you could win yourself a copy of Ingrid Jones's book. If you want to try any of these recipes, all you have to do is answer the question, how would you describe your lockdown experience in one recipe? Share your answers on the Afternoon Express Facebook page. T's and C's can be found on afternoonexpress.co.za. Competition closes at 12 p.m. Monday, the 16th of August. Thank you.